to take coordinated and consistent measures against trafficking. The resolution was adopted as well by member states in 2013 and officially designated July 30 as the World Day Against Trafficking. Actually, that is for my benefit. Knowing the history of this important day, I know that all of you have been doing this work for several years already. I am happy to be with you today to celebrate this year's World Day Against Trafficking with the theme, Ituloy ang Laban Contra Human Trafficking. As I have been head of this department, the Department of Social Welfare and Development, for barely a month, I would like to acknowledge and thank the DSWD team headed by Undersecretary Dilma Cabrera, the members of our Protective Services Bureau who are here somewhere, can they please stand up? And the whole DSWD team for their strong commitment to serve the victims of trafficking and their families. Trafficking of people has been a concern for a long time now. The International Labor Organization estimates, my estimate is lower than the estimate of the ambassador, I think yours is more current, 21 million people to be victims of forced labor globally. This includes victims of human trafficking for labor and sexual exploitation. In the Philippines, the data that we got was from Rappler, a social news network, and it places the figures around 140,000 to 160,000. Perhaps Secretary Aguirre will have more updated statistics. This figure includes human trafficking and situations of forced labor and servitude. Women and children, especially from indigenous families and from remote areas of the Philippines, are most vulnerable to varying forms of forced labor and sex trafficking. Internally displaced persons from disaster-affected communities are subjected to sex trafficking, domestic servitude, forced begging, and forced labor in small factories not only in Metro Manila, but also in Metro Cebu, Central and Northern Luzon, and urbanized areas in Mindanao. Almost 3 years since